welcome, welcome. This is your show, the Prophet Paul Jackson. I'm so excited to be with you another time. Welcome to Morning Glory. Your morning's motivation and inspiration to start your day. Because the best way to start your day is with God. I want you to understand that the philosophy for Morning Glory is that manna don't fall in the daytime. It is just before dawn. That's our philosophy here. Amen. So God bless you as you take the time out to be with me another time. Ili mushta karushta bankante movaste kunte iva. It will be a world of blessing. It will be a time of blessing and transformation. I want you to know that the Lord Jesus Christ has a word for you this morning. The Lord Jesus Christ is a word for somebody. So I want you to take the time out and to share the broadcast. Take the time out to share the broadcast. Copy the link and spread it on all your social media platform, your WhatsApp. Make sure you share it in all your WhatsApp contacts, all your WhatsApp groups. Amen. On your social media, your Facebook, your Instagram, your Twitter, all of them. Share. Learn to be a blessing. Learn to be a blessing. Learn to be a blessing. Every single world changer is a blessing to somebody. You don't know whose life you can alter this morning and change it totally. You don't know who right now is contemplating suicide. And this word that you will send will give them hope. This word that you send to them will allow them to see there's more to life than what meets the eye. They will say to themselves, why do I want to kill myself for them when God has blessed me so much? Share the broadcast. Share the broadcast. Amen. Father, we bless your name today. We thank you for life. We thank you for the words of God. We pray for clarity, that it will be crystal clear to every listener, no matter their age group, no matter their class, their creed, or wheresoever their country may be. The Holy Spirit will bring it to their level this morning, and that a word will touch them. I pray, Father, that a word will be lighted upon Jacob, that it can transfer into Israel. A word will light upon somebody this morning, that they'll be able to transfer to someone. Amen. Hope you have shared. Amen. And prepare yourself for being a blessing. So let me say a very special welcome to each and every single one of you. Amen. To all our first time viewers, God bless you. I want you to understand that we appreciate you right here on City of Our Lord God Ministry. Those that have been faithful consistently, you are more than a blessing to this ministry. Those that have been faithful consistently, you are more than a blessing to this ministry. God bless you. God bless you. Even our silent viewers, those that have been watching but have never said something, you are also an extra blessing to this ministry. Amen. You are also an extra blessing. So God bless you, beloved ones, and welcome to each and every single one of you. Amen. We're in Psalms 27 and verse 13. Psalms 27 and verse 13. That's where we're going this morning. Psalms 27 and verse 13. It says, I had fainted unless I have believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I had fainted unless I believe to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Amen. I want you to understand this morning that the psalmist was going through a particular situation, and he's expressing himself what is taking place on the inside and also what would happen to him on the outside. He said, I had fainted, meaning he was at a period of weakness in his life. Many of you this morning are at a place of weakness in your life, and you're wondering, what should I do? What will become of this situation? What will come of me? The psalmist said, I had fainted. And a person that will faint physically or spiritually, it means that they are weak. They are losing something. They are losing something, or they don't have something. Because if you're losing blood, you will faint. If you're thirsty, you will faint. You can faint. So there's something that you are losing this morning, or something that you need this morning, that is allowing you to faint or to get weary. Because before you faint, it means that you get weary. So the psalmist was getting weary because of something that he never had, or something that he was losing. And he expressed himself and said, I had fainted. You are in that particular predicament this morning. There's something that you need, and there are some things that you're losing that is causing you to become weary. So what was it that caused the psalmist David to go through this predicament? What is it that can allow you to take a licking and keep on clicking? Oh my God Almighty, I'm speaking to somebody. He said, I'd have fainted unless I believe. Unless I believe, had believe. So it was his belief that alters his behavior. His belief was what keeps him. I want you to understand that no matter what you're going through this morning, keep on believing God. You may be in a situation that is unfavorable, but keep on believing God. If you're in a one room this morning, believe him, Mako Shakata, for that mansion. Believe him for that dream house. Oh, Makendul Shtada, who am I talking to this morning? If you're still taking bus and taxi, believe him for that car. If you're still alone, if you're single, believe him for that husband. Mine can do steady, bro. If you're barren this morning, believe him for a child. No matter what you're going to, believe him. Believe him. Believe in God, the Bible said, and he shall be established. Believe his prophet, so shall he prosper. Believe him to multiply your business. Believe him this morning for a promotion. Let your belief alter your behavior. Let your belief make you talk with confidence. He said, I would have fainted. That's what the psalmist said. I was weak and I could have collapsed. My God, unless I believe. Believe to see. I want you to know that believe is synonymous to what you see. What you believe is synonymous to what you see. So if you're seeing too much failure this morning, it means that you believe in failure. Oh, makashakata. If you're seeing too much poverty, maybe you believe in poverty. Anything you're seeing too much, maybe you believe in it. If you're seeing financial crisis and experiencing financial crisis too much, maybe you believe in it. Because belief is synonymous to what you see. Notice what he said. He said, I would have fainted unless I believe to see. Believe to see. Believe to see. Meaning your belief will make you see things that is not even there. Oh, makashakata. Both positive and negative. So your belief can allow you to see what is not there. Be it negative or be it positive. So if you believe God for your healing, you will see your healing one day coming. My God, who am I speaking to this morning? If you believe God, you will see that house coming. You will see that car. You will see that husband. You will see that children. If you believe, you will see it. I want you to understand, believe until you see it and look for it until it comes to pass. Manda sikuti baha. Believe it until you see it and look for it until it comes to pass. Who am I talking to this morning? Maybe I'm wasting your time. Mangush tararabazubrakata. Meka rushte bele munko te dedebe. Maybe I'm wasting your time this morning. I thought this word was for somebody. I ain't seen nobody talking to me. I thought this word was for somebody. I thought I had a word from God for somebody this morning. Who is that person that this word is for? I would have fainted, the man of God said, unless I believe to see the goodness. What is he looking for? He's looking for goodness. I want you to understand that when I wake up, I'm not looking for poverty. I'm not looking for trouble. I'm not looking for heartbreak. I'm looking for the goodness. I'm looking to see the goodness. I want you to understand. Stop look for poverty. Stop look for destruction. Stop look for things to complain in your life. And look for things in your life to give God glory. Look for things in your life to bless God for. Ma, shinde bo konte deba. I would have fainted, beloved ones, unless I had believed to see the goodness. The goodness is that. That's what we're looking for this morning. We're not looking for poverty. We're looking for prosperity. Maka shakata. We are looking for the goodness of God. Kembushti bankunte dedebe. We're looking for the goodness of God this morning in the land. My God Almighty, in the land, not in the land of the dead, but in the land of the living, in the land of the living. I would have fainted unless I believed to see the goodness of God in the land of the living. Many of you like talk about when you go to heaven, what you're going to eat or what you're going to drink. Nothing is wrong with that. Nothing is wrong with the streets of gold and the blessings that God has for us in heaven. But there are blessings that he has for us on earth, and I need my blessing. Because the psalmist said, what I was believing God for, what is in heaven is short. But I'm believing God to see goodness in my lifetime. Is there anybody that is believing God to see goodness in his lifetime? Goodness in your lifetime. Goodness and mercy to follow you. I want you to understand. I was talking to a lady. And the lady was saying something to me. And I was talking. We were having a conversation. And she said to me. She said, my reward is in heaven. I say to her, that means I have to go and die before I get that reward. There are persons, church people, they are so stingy and mean and selfish many times that when they don't want to be a blessing to you, they say your blessing is in heaven. When they are mean sometimes and they don't want to be a blessing to you, they say your blessing is in heaven. I know my blessing is in heaven, but there are blessings that are up on the earth for me and I need them now. I don't know about you. Because some persons, like they're sending you to your grave early. Go for your blessing in heaven. Go on dead. Go die. I know that I have blessing in heaven. I know that my reward is in heaven. But the psalmist said, what I believe in God to see now is the one that is in the land of the living. There are blessings for you in the land of the living. Believe God for them. There's a house for you in the land of the living. There's a car for you in the land of the living. There's a husband for you in the land of the living. There's a wife for you in the land of the living. There are children for you in the land of the living. There's businesses for you in the land of the living. Mako shakatadaba. There's a dangerous job for you in the land of the living. Mankushtadadaba. Believe God to see what is in the land of the living for you. And know that there is dangerous blessings in heaven. Dangerous, extra, extra dangerous blessings and reward for us in heaven. But there is something for you in the land of the living. Do you want that this morning? The psalmist says, if I never see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living, I would have died. My God Almighty. Mantikurishtaba, meaning you need things in this life to strengthen you and to build your courage and your faith and to keep you. The psalmist said, I would have fainted unless I believe. I would have fainted unless I believe. Your belief will keep you from falling. Your belief will keep you in difficult situation. I would have fainted unless I had believed to see. What is it you're believing to see this morning? Oh mashakunta dadaba. Ribankuntele brosta kentushta miangwa. What is it that you're believing to see this morning? If you really believe, you're going to see. Let me tell you that. If you really believe, you're going to see it. Because remember that belief alters your behavior. Belief alters your behavior. If you believe that you're a Muslim, you're going to start Eel Allah and going to wear Muslim clothes. All manner of stupidness you begin to do for Allah. If you believe that you're a monk, you're shaving head bald. And start praise Buddha. If you're a woman, you believe you're a nun, you're going to start do some rubbish if you believe. So believe alters your behavior. What is it that you're believing God to see this morning? I would have fainted, beloved one, unless I believe to see what you want God to do for you. Believe to see what you want God to do for you in the land of the living. Because there are blessings and prosperity for you in the land of the living. There are dangerous things for you to experience in the land of the living. I would have fainted, beloved ones, unless I believe to see the goodness. To see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. So God bless you, beloved ones. This is yours truly, the prophet Paul Jackson, saying, the Lord God be with you. Amen. Every single world changing, you know what time it is. Every single world changing, you know what time it is. It's time to like the video. It's time to give the video a thumbs up. It's time to declare, I am a world changer. Oh, makashakata. It's time to believe that you are a world changer. It's time to believe that you are a world changer. It's time to believe to see. It's time to believe to see. Ikonto moshakunta. Rimbankuti debezu prakata dadaba. It's time to believe to see. So God bless you, beloved ones. Make sure you like the video before you leave. Make sure you like the video before you leave. Make sure you like the video before you leave. See you tonight. See you tonight, 8 p.m. Jamaica time. See you tonight, 8 p.m. Jamaica time. So God bless you, beloved ones. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, amen and amen.